Assalamualaikum and a very good day to everyone. Welcome to Confluence Technique Academy webinar. Before we start, let me go through this disclaimer. High investment risk, trading foreign exchange, forex on margin carries a high level of risk and may not be suitable for all investors. The high level of leverage can work against you as well as for you. Please consider whether trading forex is appropriate for you in light of your experience, goals as an investor, financial resources and risk appetite. The possibility exists that you could lose some or all of your initial investment, therefore you should not invest money that you cannot afford to lose. You should be aware of all risks associated with forex trading and look for advice of any independent financial advisor if you have any doubts. Confluence Technique Academy opinion, any opinion, news, research, analysis or other information provided by Confluence Technique Academy should be interpreted as general market commentary, not as an investment advice. Confluence Technique Academy will not accept liability for any loss or damage, including but not limited to any loss of profit that may arise directly or indirectly from the use or reliance on such information. Now we got that out of the way. My name is Zulkifli Abdul Razak. You can call me Zul. I am a full-time trader. I have more than 10 years experience in trading either forex, equity, commodities or any financial or most of the financial market derivative. Today we are going to cover the topic of the introduction to forex trading, the trading process. In the first webinar, entitled Introduction to Forex Trading, we look at the four pillars of trading, the four skills that a trader need to trade the financial market, namely fundamental analysis, technical analysis, risk management, trading psychology. Basically, fundamental analysis, we are looking at the value, the strength of a currency, if you're talking about forex, of a currency, of an economy, based on the fiscal policy and the monetary policy. These two are part of the economic policy of the country. We also look at technical analysis, basically we were looking at what is the function of technical analysis. Basically, technical analysis is to know what are the significant levels in the chart, what are the significant prices in a chart. We look at risk management and why it is important for a trader. Basically, we look at three things. One is the time factor. You need time in the market. You need time to learn the market. Number two, you need to know what is the appropriate trading size. How much you want to expose, you want to put in the market when you are trading. And number three, you want to know what type of trader you are. Know yourself as a trader. And the fourth one is trading psychology, the most important part of a trader, trading skill, where there are three components. The first one is knowing yourself as a trader. Number two, know your strategy, how you enter the market. And number three is basically to know the market. These are the basics that a trader need in order to participate, in order to trade in financial market. Today we are going to look at trading process. What are the thing? What are the basic things that you need to know when you want to develop your trading process? First of all, you need the necessary trading tools. Number one, you need before this. These are the things that you need before you start trading. The trading tools, namely one is research articles. What I mean by research articles are any articles that is written that about a currency pair that talk about the trend, the direction of the currency, what is happening, why the currency pair goes to that direction, what are the market levels, the significant levels that we as a trader should be looking at. I give you an example here. This is an example of something written by Maybank Singapore. Basically, they're talking about what is happening today. The OPEC disaccord. There's a meeting among the oil producer countries today. They're talking about either want to cut or want to freeze or do nothing. Those are the three things that market are keeping an eye on. And we are talking about the significant levels and the possible directions that currencies pair are looking at. Okay, this is an example of a research article. Okay, we are done with that. News feed. There are various sites that offers good news feed. For example, forexlive.com runs Squawk, even on Twitter. You can use Twitter as news feed. Do subscribe, do follow those Bloomberg, your Reuters, your CNBC, your Wall Street Journal. These are the news feed. Economic Calendar, the most important, the most popular one among retail traders is the Forex Factory. You can go to forexfactory.com. Forex Factory, one word. And the charting software, the most popular is MetaTrader 4. These are the basic trading tools that a trader need to participate, to trade in the financial market. Okay, first, when you develop a trading process, is basically you are developing a routine in your trading, in trading that involve these four phases. Number one is the knowledge phase. Number two is the analysis phase. Number three, execution phase. And number four is the review phase. Okay, when you're talking about knowledge phase, basically you want to understand market as a whole. These are the things that you do before you even open the chart. Basically, you need to gather all this knowledge before you actually trade. You need to understand what is financial market. You need to understand what is forex market, understand why forex market exists, and what are its rules. Understand the four pillars: the fundamental analysis, your technical analysis, your risk management, and also your trading psychology, and how to apply all this into your trade plan. Okay, let me repeat. In the knowledge phase, you need to understand what is financial market, what are the components inside financial market, understand what is forex market, why forex market exists, and what are its roles in the financial market. Understand the four pillars: fundamental analysis, technical analysis, risk management, and trading psychology, and how to apply all this into your trade plan. That is the knowledge phase. Analysis phase. When you are doing analysis, there are two parts. Number one is the fundamental analysis, and number two is your technical analysis. Okay, refresh the big picture view. Basically, you want to know what is the big trend of the currency. Don't look at pair. you need to analyze a currency by its own merit. For example, if you are looking at Euro USD, you don't look at the pair Euro USD. You look at Euro, and after that, you look at USD. Okay, an example of big picture view is looking at the monetary policy and the fiscal policy. For example, at the moment for Euro, the European Central Bank, ECB, under its president Draghi, Mario Draghi, it is going through the quantitative easing policy. Basically, what they are doing is they are printing currencies electronically and buying bonds from the central bank in governments under the European zone. And this will increase supply in the economy. Why they are doing that? Because they want to increase spending in the economy among the people in the Eurozone, among the companies in the Eurozone, because the Eurozone is facing inflation problem. What I mean by facing a low inflation problem, the inflation target for ECB is 2%, whereas the actual inflation at the moment is very, very low. It's below 1, if I'm not mistaken. I don't have the figure with me at the moment, but it is low. So ECB is going through something that we call an easing process, and they are increasing supply of money in the economy. When you increase supply, price goes down. Okay, so Euro you are looking to sell, whereas USD, the market is expecting Federal Reserve, through its FOMC meeting this December, to hike the rate. The interest rate in the US, United States, at the moment stands at 0.5%. So market is expecting FOMC in its meeting on 14 December. For us, Malaysia, is 15 December at 3 a.m. in the morning, to hike rate up to 25 base point. Okay, 0.25. So market, this is something that you call tightening policy. Okay, so USD, when you tighten the policy, meaning you are decreasing the supply of currency in the economy. So when supply goes down, price goes up. Okay, USD you are looking to buy. So by having this big picture view, Euro you are selling because of the quantitative easing policy by ECB, while Federal Reserve is tightening its policy, is planning to, the market is expecting it to increase the interest rate, a tightening policy. So USD you go and buy, so you match this to Euro USD, Euro you sell, USD you buy, so the pair Euro USD you are looking to sell. Okay, later we talk about where to sell. Okay, but looking at the big picture view only is not enough, because market does have its own supply and demand. Market does have its own mood every day. Market receives various data every day. We need to identify the prevailing sentiment. What is the current sentiment in the market? What drives the market in previous session? What happened overnight? What did market do during the current session open? What data is coming out, and what are market expectation on the data? This is what you call the intraday sentiment. What is happening now? Okay? So having the big picture of, I take the example of Euro USD again. So the big picture is to sell Euro USD. But if the level of Euro USD is at the oversold area, that is talking about technical, and the sentiment is good for Euro, bad for USD. For example, the NFP data, the non-farm payroll data, or something happened that shows there is weakness in US economy. So that is not the time for you to short Euro USD. Okay, that is what you call a pullback. Okay. Again, on analysis phase, you need to ask yourself, when you are doing this analysis, ask this question: why you enter this trade now? What actually going to drive price towards your direction, towards your take profit level? Okay, there must be something that pulls your entry towards your target. For example, just now you were shorting Euro USD, you enter at a pullback, everything is fine. There must be something that is pulling your trade. For example, this is where something that you call buy the rumors, sell the news kind of thing. Market is expecting Federal Reserve going to hike the rate on 14 December. So if there's any pullback on USD, say Euro USD just now, and you enter at a higher place or at a higher price, so market is expecting it to go lower until 14 December. That is the catalyst of your trade. That is the magnet that pulls your trade from a higher level towards a lower level. Euro USD, you're looking to sell on pullbacks because of the FOMC event. Okay, technical analysis, basically you are looking at a higher time frame to do your analysis and enter at a lower time frame. We will go, we will cover that when we cover technical analysis in later webinar. Okay, number three, the execution phase. You are in the market. Okay, basically you don't have any power on the market after you enter the market. You only have power on the market before you enter the market. The knowledge phase, the analysis phase. But when you are in the market, you don't have any power on the where price is going. You are at the mercy of the market. Anything could happen. There would be earthquake, there would be war, things like that. So when you are in the market, do monitor your news feed, your audio squad. Just now I did mention about the news feed. Maybe one of the good one is Twitter. Number two, Forex Live. For audio squad, you can use Run Squad. That is a paid service. Your risk management elements are very, very important. What I mean by risk management elements is you need to have a stop loss, you need to have a target when you are entering a position. Do monitor the news feed, do monitor the audio squad. Look out, say you are selling Euro USD because there is a good US data and there is a bad Euro data. Okay, so price is going down for Euro USD, then suddenly something happened, maybe a riot in Wall Street area. So if a riot happened in the financial district of one's country, it might affect the financial market. So if you hear anything on the audio squad or read something in the Forex Live, you can exit the position manually. Okay, known factor, upcoming risk event. This could be the catalyst, the magnet that is pulling your trade towards your target. Plan to deal with any possibility when you already execute your trade. And another thing, when you are setting stop loss, market does not know your 10 pip, your 20 pip, your 50 pips, your 100 pips. When you are setting stop loss based on whatever strategy you are entering the market, always look for a level that under current condition, under with your analysis, it will not be triggered. One common mistake among retail trader is setting a very, very minimal stop losses. Stop loss, yeah. So, for example, you have something that moves 200 pips daily, GBP, JPY, for example. Okay? If you are putting 20 pips or less as your stop loss for this pair, it will be hit in no time. Okay, so when you are setting your stop loss, you set it at a level where under current condition, it will not be triggered. If it is triggered, meaning you are wrong in your analysis, take your stop loss, move on. Okay, another important thing in the execution phase is you always monitor yourself. Always focus on your initial analysis. That is why it is very, very important for you to write your trade plan. A trade plan should have, number one, best opportunity. Write in your trade plan why the currency moves now. Okay, best price, the overall value of the currency, the key price levels, either you use pivot level, either you use the Fibonacci levels, either you use moving averages, either you use support and resistance, trend line, Ichimoku, Bollinger Band, or whatever technique that you are using, you want to enter. Basically, when you are doing technical analysis, you are doing this. You are doing pullback, meaning you are doing, you are looking for support become resistance level, resistance become support level. Okay, we will touch that further in our technical analysis webinar. ADR, average daily range. Identify what is the average daily range of a currency pair. If the currency pair have an average daily range of 200 pips, for example, Euro USD is 150 to 180 pips. Say the currency already moved down 120 pips. So you have an average of 30 to 50 pips to go. But you are entering an intraday position, yet you put your target level at 100 pips. Will it be triggered? Ask yourself that. Okay. Correction move. Identify whether the correction move already done, already finished. There are so many strategy outside there. Basically, entries are divided into two. One is contrarian. Another one is momentum. Contrarian meaning if the price goes up, to you that is you are looking for pullback. Okay. Pullback entry. That is those who are using the Fibonacci retracement, those who are using the Bollinger Band, those who are using the moving averages and so on. And number two is the momentum trading. Momentum trading, when price breaks a certain level and pull back, you are expecting the price to go towards and to follow its momentum. Okay, so you want to identify these corrections move. We will cover that in our technical analysis webinar. Multi-high, multi-low levels. This is more for those who are doing the position trading. You wait for pullbacks. 80% of the time, price will make a pullback. We'll do a pullback when it's hit a multi-high or a multi-low level. Sometimes, it is best to just execute the trade. There is something that you call a 5-minute trading strategy. For example, the chairperson of FOMC, of Federal Reserve, Janet Yellen, she's known as a soft dovish, meaning she's always careful in her statement, she always follow the script. Suddenly she says something that is supportive of USD. Okay, you heard it on your audio squawk, you read about it on your Forex Live feed, you read about it in your Twitter. When to enter position, just enter. Okay, and the most important is your conviction. Okay, your conviction. You must be convinced that you are right in your position. Okay, look at your trade plan, wait for the price pullback, let the trade follow its own, follow the market, yeah, follow the plan. The last one, review plan. Okay, this is the main cause why most traders fail. This is the thing that kills most traders' account. To look for consistency, you need to know yourself. Always, always, always focus on your, not your weakness, focus on your strength. Be a positive trader. Build your confidence. Identify what is your niche. Either your niche is certain currency pairs, your niche is certain market time, or your niche is certain trading technique. Okay? After you identify what is your niche, then you review your weaknesses. Okay? Review plan, trade result, reasons for trade result, lessons from trade. These four things. In the review plan, you should write what is your trade result, reasons for the trade result, and what are the lessons that you learn from a trade. Okay, basically we are talking about two. Number one, in the execution phase, we are talking about trade plan, and number two, we are talking about a review plan. In the review plan, you want to look at your trade result, you want to know why, what are the reasons for the trade result, and the lessons you learn from the trade. Always, always, always focus on your strength, not on your weakness. Work on your weakness after you identify what are your strengths in trading. Always be a positive trader. That is how you build your confidence. That is how you build your consistency in trading. We touched on this in the first webinar. Identify what type of trader you are. If you are position trader, you use short-term sentiment to enter on the long-term trade where you think price will eventually reach. Let us look at the example of Euro-USD once again. Euro-USD, you're looking to short because ECB is going for accommodative, is going for easing policy. They are buying government bonds under the quantitative easing policy. Okay, they are supplying the market with currencies, with money. So supply goes up, price goes down for euro. USD, you are going for long, because Federal Reserve is going for tightening policy. They are expected to hike rate on the 14th December FOMC. That is 15th December 3 a.m. in Malaysia. So you have all this info. How do you enter as a position trader? Okay, you wait for something, bad data on USD or good data on Euro. But all this data, it, as long as the policy doesn't change, you are looking at the data divergence between, you are looking at divergence between market sentiment and the policy. Okay, good data for Euro, bad data for USD, you will see a huge pullback on Euro USD. Okay, that is what position trader look for. Number two, day trader. As a day trader, always focus on sentiment analysis. You want to know what happened today, what is the market feeling now, what is the market feeling overnight, what can pull your trade towards that direction. The best is if you can combine the fundamental analysis. Again, taking the example of Euro USD, you want to sell, something happened, there's a pullback, and today's sentiment is good to sell Euro USD. Bad data on Euro, good data for USD. So you are looking for pullback technically, then you follow the trend. That is an example of the best analysis for a day trader. Scalping. There are so many. If you have all the time in the world to look at the chart, at your chart all the time, especially with the availability of apps on our smartphones, don't trade a longer time period. Position trader cannot afford to have 20 positions running all the time. Okay. Because they are in the market for a long time, and normally they have 2-3 positions. Day traders, more or less the same, 4-5 positions, 3. But if you are, you have all the time in the world and you are looking at your chart all the time, you will enter the position even you don't see a perfect setup. Be a scalper. Scalping is a form of day trading. Your focus is more on technical, the price range in the market. We will discuss about that more in our technical analysis webinar. And most important is your trade management. Okay. Stop losses is very important for scalpers. What you want to do when you are scalping the market is you want to enter and the price move. You don't want to enter and hold and the price goes sideways. That is not scalping. That is what killing most retail trader account. When they scalp, then somehow the scalping position become a swing position if they float negative. There's a drawdown on the account. Yet they enter another position, enter another position. So this is where, remember in the first webinar we talked about speculator versus commercial traders. This is where you identify yourself as speculator trader. You don't love your position too much. If it is time to cut loss, if it's time for, if the price going towards your stop loss, take it. Take your losses. Okay? So these three: position trader, day trader, and scalping. Always don't look for holy grail. There is no one strategy that fits all market condition. Always look for knowledge. Always look for be a versatile trader. Always look for what. I'm not saying that you should be a butterfly trader. What I mean by butterfly trader, one day you do this, you swear by this strategy, tomorrow or next week you go by, you say this strategy is rubbish and you move on to another strategy. No. The most important for a trader is learn different techniques, look for something that fits you as a trader, backtest it, whatever you do, look for something that you are comfortable with, that you understand. Okay, there is no two traders that are exactly the same. One, you will have a different equity. Number two, knowledge. Number three, time of trading, and so many other factors. Yeah, so always look for that strategy that you understand, your own strategy if possible. Okay, your entry should be based on market condition and prevailing sentiment, and all strategies must come with a trade plan. Okay, so let me recap. A trading process involves four things, four phases. Number one, knowledge phase. Number two is the analysis phase. Number three is the execution phase. And number four is the review phase. That's it for our webinar for now. See you guys in the next webinar. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Have a good day.